Have you ever thought about what it takes to run all the cloud services and emerging AI technologies that drive our digital lives? It's probably no surprise that the massive data centers that power these services use a lot of energy. But what might surprise you is they can also use another important resource, water, as a way to transfer heat. That's because one of the biggest operational challenges for data centers is temperature control. The servers inside process enormous amounts of data, and that creates lots and lots of heat. If that heat isn't removed, the servers can overheat and the equipment could fail. Getting rid of all that heat takes energy, and yes, water. But water, just like energy, is precious. So data center operators have to get creative. They carefully consider each location's unique climate and water needs to find a smart, sustainable balance. It's all about finding ways to stay cool while keeping the planet in mind. So, how do data centers optimize energy and water use to keep those servers cool? It starts with separate systems for cooling the servers, where the heat comes from, and cooling at the building level, where the heat is removed from the facility. For cooling at the server level, there are two main options. Air cooling uses air conditioning and fans to move hot air out and cool air in. The other option is liquid cooling, which is a closed-loop system that sends cooling liquid directly over the processing chips inside servers, where it absorbs the heat and carries it away. The liquid is then cooled down and recirculated. Whether the servers are cooled by air or by liquid, the heat produced is transferred from one closed loop to another and routed to the building cooling system via a heat exchanger. Building-level cooling methods have varying water and energy requirements. Air cooling at the building level uses air conditioning and fans to cool liquid and reject the heat to the outside air. It doesn't use water, but does use a lot of energy. Evaporative cooling rejects heat using fans and water that have been converted to water vapor and is released to the outside. This option can consume a lot of water, but is much more energy efficient. Either type of server cooling system can be used with either type of building cooling system. And there are a couple less common cooling methods, which are only possible for certain locations. Geothermal cooling, for example, circulates cold water from large lakes or natural sources nearby to remove heat from the building and then returns the water back to the source. In other cases, heat generated in a data center can be repurposed for use by local communities. The cooling solutions that a data center implements directly affect its consumption of water and energy. Data center operators have to balance their use of energy and water resources in a responsible way, in addition to considering which cooling methods and which combination of methods will most efficiently manage heat. They take into account the unique climate, power constraints, and water stress for each data center location to find the right balance. Evaporative cooling, for instance, can be an effective way to manage energy use in areas with power-constrained grids or limited access to renewable energy. On the other hand, in water-stressed regions, where water needs to be prioritized for other uses, evaporative cooling should be avoided. As demand for data center capacity grows, especially for intensive AI workloads, responsible design choices can help support a more sustainable digital future. To learn more about high-performance data centers and how they operate, check out these other videos.